I may not have a lot of money, but what I got, I'll give to you. I don't care too much for money.
Mom told you to stay out of the treehouse. It's dangerous. Now get down.
Listen, I think that the girls are gonna have a little difficulty with that one step. You know,
it comes with the arms.
I think we should make it a little harder.
My God, you are statue.
You know what? No, listen. It doesn't matter if they know the whole routine. I mean, we have to look for rhythm.
That's true. I'll get it.
Hello, Cindy Mancini. Put on Channel 5 Bodyguard!
Are you serious?
Oh my gosh!
You gotta be a little homesick.
It is,
Bobby. Let me ask you, what's the one special thing you miss most about the old hometown?
Cindy's name on TV!
Mind if I get a little personal? What I really miss the most always made me feel so good after football practice.
You're so lucky.
I miss that Hydra massage machine back in the old high school gym.
Well, the old high school misses you too, Bobby Hilton. Good luck with the Hawkeyes. Stocky Jones.
Hey, you guys, it's so felony. Come on. I mean, he's got a lot on his mind, right? Football and everything.
Yeah. Okay.
Look, we're late, okay?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Going.
Thank you.
telescope yet? You better accelerate. You want to miss a sale of $1,000 in this ground larceny as it is. What, are you worried about the capital outlay?
No. I was just thinking about the cool click.
Why would you be thinking about them? They're certainly not conscious of us.
That's my point. Wouldn't you like to hang with them?
You have been hanging on Cindy Mancini's lawn for, what, 5 years? I bet she doesn't even know your name. You got a crush on Cindy? Huh?
No.
Well, most living organisms do, but she's way out of our league. She's even out of their league.
Okay, freeze! Good! All right. Good.
Yeah.
Oh, good. Look, here comes the Spoon's master himself.
Hey, ladies, Miss Mancini. Looking good.
Thank you.
Like I knew you would.
Why don't you take a shower, Quince?
A cold one?
Yeah, definitely.
Let's take a flat of full pads here. I'll stick this here, no question.
Hey, guys. Back to school party at my place.
Cool.
I'm there.
I'm thrilled.
Check it out, dudes. New recruits. Being a senior's gonna be a beautiful thing. I can taste it now, man. Hold my back.
This is supposed to be the biggest year of our lives. The prom, parties, homecoming. We're supposed to have memories.
Memories. We'll have plenty of memories. Yearbook committee, video parlor, car games on Saturday nights.
That isn't for retards. I'm sorry, I didn't mean it that way. And we do have a lot of great memories. But be honest, wouldn't you like to be popular?
And have to be in a clique?
No. What happened to us? We were all friends in elementary.
That's because we were all forced to be in the same room together. But hey, junior high, high school, forget it. Jocks became jocks. Cheerleaders became cheerleaders. We became us. I like us.
I just think it would be more fun to party with those guys our senior year. Go to the games.
We go to all the games.
We sit in the visiting section, Kenneth. At our own school.
Where have you
been? There's the answer, buddy. If you want to be popular, you get one of those. And you get one of those.
Yeah, right. My 1500 wouldn't buy the wheel.
You can rent them, you know.
Yeah.
Looks, clean, Dad.
Oh, thank you, son. You know, anytime you want to borrow this little beauty for a night on the town, it's yours.
Thanks. You missed this one, huh?
Okay. I get it.
Mother!
Oh. Beauty runs in its family, and it runs fast.
Brock?
Oh, I see you met my little baby.
Baby? I thought she was your little sister.
Oh, Brock!
Mother? Mom? Can I borrow your sweet outfit tonight?
Cindy, I said no.
Good word, Mom.
So, I'm glad you made the squad. You know, you girls are so important to the team. I mean, your help is so crucial between games, too. Keeping our spirits up.
Great. What can I do to help?
Ronald, not at the table, please.
So, have you saved up enough money?
Yeah, $1,500. Yeah, I mowed 331 miles of grass this summer. That's $4.54 per mile.
The Ronald Miller story.
My life on a mower.
How much is the microscope?
Telescope?
Oh.
Now, it's $1,000 and it's on sale. And then I'm going to deposit the rest in a money market account.
I'm proud of you, son. You worked, you earned, you saved.
You ask. Hey, Big Dave, how about spotting me a 20 to purchase some necessities?
Why, what's up, son?
Preschool jam session at Julie's.
Okay. And what about you, Ronald? You got any back-to-school parties lined up?
Yeah, the Saturday night card game.
Ooh, cards with the tarts. Hey, bro, I'm only kidding. I mean, who could beat a night of cards, chips, dips, and dorks?
Well, God, feed them and weep.
Your deal. Ronald, your deal. Let's do something different. What do you mean? We've been playing poker for 2 years. Play another game. Dealer's choice. Hearts.
Friend, isn't it?
Yeah. Wow. Now can I pet it?
I'm sorry, it's dead.
Ooh, cool outfit.
Ooh. What a severe swing.
Guys, it's no big deal. And Bobby sent me for my one.
You know, they have fine leathers down there.
Oh, yeah. The best leathers come from Rome, Paris, and Des Moines.
I don't remember this. I was just in your closet yesterday.
I probably headed somewhere else. I don't know.
Hey, friends, you want to go mingle a little bit?
My mom won't let me near suede.
It's too hard to clean.
I know. My mom feels the same way.
Did I tell any of you girls about my mini scholarship offers?
Hey, John boy!
How about we?
Yeah!
We're in time!
Oh, watch it! Oh. Sorry, hon. Don't worry, it's only wine. Just rub some salt on it, it'll come out. I mean, it's not like a ring. Well, it has an optical inverter.
Take a look. Take a look.
gives you an erect image rather than upside down.
Yeah. Ah, yes. I see the erection.
I
relate to your dilemma, Miss. I really do. But we have a policy of no exchanges, especially
after a garment has been marinated in ripple.
All right, now I will compromise. All right? I will work here after school and on weekends. Would you listen to me? I will work here after school and on weekends, and all you need to do is give me a replacement outfit as an advance.
Listen, honey. I'll repeat your alternatives one last time. You can keep your outfit and dye the rest of it cranberry, or you can purchase a new one.
Would you please help me? I will do anything. Are you high?
I want to rent you.
You want to rent me?
Yeah. You pretend you like me, and we go out for just a few weeks, and that will make me popular.
Just going out with me is not going to make you popular.
Well, I have $1,000. It says it will.
I think you've mowed one too many lawns.
You're right. I believe we have decided against purchasing the outfit.
At 8:05, I'm here, right? Relax, anyway, it's only school.
Yeah. Well, this is not my average opening day. I'm about to walk the cool hallway. I usually go the long route through the library.
Would you ease up? I mean, I'm the one who's gonna have to hold a press conference when we're sitting together, right?
Okay, now let's get this deal straight one more time. We only pretend to hang, right? No hand-holding, kissing, and I get my lunch hour off.
That's not our deal. I need more return on my investment.
Well, there's no way I'm holding your hand in public.
I mowed 286 miles for you.
Okay, one lunch.
There are 5 days in a school week.
All right, Donald, 2 lunches.
3 lunches. And the pep rally on Friday.
4 lunches, that's it.
Okay, deal. Now, just remember, this is our sworn secret for life or longer. Promise.
Yeah, I promise. Anyway, how bad could it be, right? It's only for 1 month.
No, it's 1 month.
1 month.
Okay. Now, if I'm gonna do this for one day, we have to do something about your style. I mean, it's like non-existent, okay? Take off that hat. And rub that in. Okay, take off those glasses. Go. Let me take a look at you. Aye. Nope. Turn around. Oh. Okay. Go. On your sleeve. Don't worry about it. Fine. Turn around and back up. Yes. Yes. Big improvement.
Yes.
Okay, Donald. We're ready.
Well, Cindy, one last thing.
Yeah.
My name is Ronald, not Donald.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Let's put my collar up.
Hey, dude.
Basketball trophy, put it down there. We want ours to be all alone.
Who's the dick with ears?
Oh, yeah, man. It's that Wimpus Miller guy. I don't get it.
It must be for charity.
I think that's Ronald Miller. No way. It must be a transfer. Wrong, and I think I'm puking. Hi, Pittsburgh. You all know Ronnie?
Yeah, I think. Didn't you, like, used to mow our lawn?
Yes. And you have the nicest pair of rhododendrons in town.
Rhodo-who?
Dendrums.
I'll see you guys in the back, okay? What did he say? I don't care.
Dig on your shirt.
Well, class, any interesting experiments this summer?
Yeah, well, I grew spores and fungi in my parents' refrigerators.
Now he's homeless. Can we get me in the library?
Sorry, I forgot, you know, first day.
What's with the weird outfit?
It's a designer original.
How's the new telescope?
Well, I didn't exactly buy it yet. $1,000 is a great deal to part with, and I don't.
Mr. Miller, you seem quite talkative this morning. Why don't you recite the bones of the upper appendicular skeleton? All 64.
Oh, very God, you are such a pig.
God.
Well, since you guys are all wimping out, I'll get to the main issue here. Cindy, what were you doing with the lawn boy? We're friends.
Since when?
Excuse me, Cindy. Friends?
Yeah.
Well, what about
Bobby?
Yeah. Come on, we just want some answers, all right?
Guys, why don't you take a look at my forehead? Do you see a sign that says information?
Ooh. Oh, I didn't think so.
Yeah. Good one.
Hey, come on!
that lunch was part of our deal, but I didn't think it meant the same table.
Well, I thought it would be a little more believable.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Anyway, you did treat me.
Aren't you in the wrong section? Losers are to the left.
Then I guess you'll be making a right. That's the asshole section.
Thanks.
We've only been sitting at
that
table for 3 years.
Well, look, that Wimpus Miller is parking hours
from. Why not? How bad can it be?
Cindy, come on. Okay.
You all know Ronnie?
Yeah, we were in sixth grade together. But I haven't seen him since then.
I read in the paper that you and Ricky will probably make all county, maybe even all state this season.
Oh, really? You go to the game?
Everyone.
I've never seen you there.
I have. You sit in the visiting section, don't you? Yeah, he sits there to razz the other team. It's psychological warfare.
Yeah. I almost got my butt kicked 3 times.
Now that's true spirit. Yeah. Risking your life for the team. I guess.
Guys, look at this. Ronald's over in no man's land, and he's still alive. What does he think he's doing, Ken?
He must be helping him with their homework.
Yeah. First morning of school, homework.
Okay. So, you got not again. Second morning, mom.
Oh. God, if my blood sugar level was any lower, I'd be a corpse. Oh, thanks for stopping.
No problem. I stop here every day anyway. Why didn't you eat lunch?
I don't know. I guess I just get nervous around this
place. Hi.
Hi.
Cindy.
John. Now is your chance. Why don't you go over there and invite them to come over here and join us, okay?
Good idea.
Okay.
Okay. Guys, come on, Elba. The pizza's on me.
Dude. Thanks, bro.
Ron?
Thanks, Dad.
Hey, honey, how's that new microscope?
It's a I decided to wait for the big Columbus Day sale.
Where are you off to?
I'm going to a party. John Richmond's with Cindy Mancini.
Cindy Mancini?
Mm-hmm.
Senior captain of the cheerleaders?
Yes.
Most beautiful girl in the history of this county?
Mm-hmm, that's her. Well, I'm late. I got a bolt.
Bolt? Something stinks in suburbia.
Hey. What's
it? Ronald.
Oh, Ronald.
Yes, ma'am.
Did I forget to pay you last week?
Oh, no, ma'am. I'm here to pick up Cindy.
Cindy?
Yes, ma'am, your daughter.
Oh, Cindy!
Delicious.
Bye.
I didn't get a chance to say goodbye to your mother.
She'll get over it.
Is something the matter?
Yes, there's something the matter. Ronald, I'm usually picked up in some sort of mechanized transportation, you know.
I'm sorry. It's a nice night, Cindy. It's only a few blocks.
I am not going on a nature walk. I can't believe I let you negotiate a Saturday night. I mean, what? We had lunch all week together. I stood near you in the hall. I even took you out for pizza, and I waved you at the gate yesterday. I mean, Saturday night was not part of our deal.
Bobby hasn't called.
I don't think that's any of your business.
Cindy, here Bobby was a big-time football star. But there, he's just a freshman trying to make it. I'm sure he's thinking about you.
I'm sorry.
Sorry? Hey, I'm the one who forgot my dad's car. It's just that I haven't had that many dates in the last 16, say, 17 years. So what do you think of this suit, huh? Elegant?
What's a two-word phrase for late and inconsiderate?
Oh, I got it. Ronald Miller.
Hysterical, he'll be here.
Yeah, he's probably having a late lunch with Cindy.
The least he could have done is drop off the dip and chips. The cold brew is just not the same.
So what's the real reason why they call you Big John?
Well, how about I show you?
Hey, great game, Big John.
Oh, thanks.
Hey.
So, you brought Cindy here?
No. Yes, well, we came from her house together, so, yeah.
Well, hey, anyway, you think you can handle bro?
Sure. You got an A&W?
No, you're a funny guy, though.
Okay.
Dude, I got a lot of growing up, man. I mean, bad. Oh, but there's no need for panic because John Ritzman is a socially responsible human being. Listen.
Hey.
Hi.
We're starting to buy this. I mean, he went. Totally geek. It's totally chic.
Uh-huh. What do you think?
Can I give you a ride from after school?
Yes, please. Thank
okay,
you.
See you.
All right, bye-bye. Good morning. Well, how was your weekend? Oh, it was great. How was yours? Well, Friday, really got my face rearranged by a visiting fan trying to save you a seat. And Saturday, you stood us up for cards. Hey, Sunday, you ever returned any of my calls?
Sam, I'm sorry.
Yeah, for which one?
I said I'm sorry. Can we please terminate this?
Fine.
Hey, Kevin. Let's do something this weekend, just me and you.
Okay, Friday night.
I can't.
Saturday.
I was thinking more Sunday afternoon.
Great, I'll call you for an appointment.
Oh, great, all right, I'll see you Sunday.
Yo, gentlemen, babe! How's it going?
You know, when I often offered you a ride home, it wasn't to get you to wash my car.
I don't mind. Actually, I kind of like it.
Hey, you're a hard worker. Work's not really my thing.
Cheerleading's hard work. You do it well.
I guess. But, I mean, what I mean is that I don't do much else except for shop and hang out.
You can do anything you want. Anything you put your heart and your mind into. I believe that.
I'll be right back. Do you want anything from the kitchen or anything?
No, thanks. Someday my wish is for him to hold me in his arms in a sea of deep blue. Together at last, together as two. Oh, that's beautiful. I didn't know you were a poet.
No one knows.
Even Bobby? Thank you for trusting me with these.
Well, let's just keep it between us, okay? For life longer. Promise?
Promise. But you should be proud of it. You're talented.
And you're drenched.
You really like this?
Yeah, I do, but you're missing one big essential.
You sure?
Yeah.
What am I missing?
I'd like to see those, please. Very cool.
How much are they?
Don't worry about it. They're on me. Hey, it's off the top. Okay.
Bye.
Good to see you, honey. Can't believe you won't tell me where we're going. What are we doing? Horseback riding? A picnic?
No. Since it's our last official date, I thought we could check out one of my favorite places.
Well, what's in the box?
You'll find out.
Okay.
Trust me. It'll be fun.
Okay, let me guess. What, are we out of gas? Come on, Ronald, I thought we outlawed this kind of stuff.
Follow me.
Wait a second, you're nuts. I mean, I don't usually scale walls on dates.
You can do it.
Of course I can do it.
heard about this place. The airplane junkyard.
Graveyard.
This is the real history. Not the stuff we memorize in books.
Are these real bullet holes right here?
Yep. Follow me. The Navy found this one last year off the coast of Japan. Did a corrosion study on it. After 40 years at the bottom of the ocean, this is all it rusted. My grandparents sure knew how to make things that last.
How do you know all this stuff?
Well, the pilot who ditched it in 1944, he came back a few weeks ago to take a look at this. He stood here and looked at this thing the whole day.
God, there are mountains up there.
And valleys, canyons, and plains.
What's that thing up there that looks like a star sapphire? What's that?
Tycho. An asteroid crashed there and broke the moon.
Broke the moon?
Yeah. Made a crack in the moon 100 times the size of the Grand Canyon. And on the right is a sea of tranquility. The first spaceship from Earth landed there. The day I was born.
That's why you're so into astrology, right?
Astronomy. No. It's just up there, it's a future world. By the time of my dad's age, people will be living there and working. Maybe even us.
The moon looks different now. It's not as mysterious or romantic.
I'm sorry I ruined it for you.
You didn't ruin it. You just changed it, I guess.
There's something really important we need to discuss.
I was wondering when you'd bring this up.
I'm new at all of this. We're gonna have to rely on your experience.
Well, let's just do it naturally. You know, with no planning.
How do we do it? Our official breaking up tomorrow.
Right, that's exactly what I was thinking about. The breakup, us ascending our fake relationship. I mean, I don't even know whoever believed it. Us going out, you, me. Right.
Yeah, it does seem kind of unrealistic. Okay, so, how shall we do it? Stage a big fight? A lover's quarrel?
anything to fight about.
Oh, that's okay. We can make something.
Let's see what people fight about. We wouldn't want to damage your reputation.
Reputation?
But I think a small, dignified ceremony is probably the best way to...
Me? Yeah! Keep moving. Thank you, Cindy.
Have a good night now. I got a reputation, baby!
Is that easily expressed?
Yeah, there you go.
Hi.
Hi. I did a little thinking about last night, and I think that now is the time that we had our little talk.
About what?
Us. You know me.
Okay.
Great.
Well, I did a little thinking, too. No, actually, I did quite a bit of thinking, and I decided that you're breaking me.
What?
Broke. Bankrupt. Chapter 11?
What are you talking about?
This. I'm dry. Hey, I can't keep up with you. I'm not a bank. 11.
Would you stop it, please? This isn't dignified.
Dignified? One month, you draped all over me like a cheap fucking suit. Now I'm not dignified?
This is not necessary. Would you show some maturity?
Like you're precious, Bobby?
Yeah.
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 Well, if I was as mature as him, I probably wouldn't have called you either. I'm tired of you comparing me to Bobby. And in fact, I'm tired of you. Period.
Poor Cindy. It's awful the way Ron annihilated her.
I mean, I don't know what she ever saw in him. He's such a heartbreaker.
Yeah. That's it.
The Rapster, man. You're one badass dude.
Hey, listen, you don't mind if I try to get tired of Cindy now that you're finished with your game?
No. Loved it, man.
All right. I was a great act this morning. That slap was so real. We are talking Oscar nominations.
Yeah, well, we gave him a good show. The audience loved it.
What an excellent 4 weeks. Your friends really took to me. All because of you.
Man, it was like a job. I mean, you bailed me, and I pretended to like you. And I was only honoring our rental contract.
Yeah, well, it worked. Jeez. Popularity sure beats being treated like a social leper.
Let me tell you.
Popularity isn't perfect. I mean, it almost feels like a job sometimes. Do you remember that suede outfit that I wore?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, that was me trying to impress people. I have to work at it. So does everybody else.
Cindy? So keep your poetry in.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Ronald, whatever happens with the popularity thing, you know, stay yourself. Don't change to please me.
Me change? Never.
That's right, I'm here.
Hey, Babbitts, how you doing, man?
Good to see all the ladies. You're beautiful.
That's right.
Mom, Dad, send money, please. I'm broke.
Yeah. Hey, man. Good to see you, man. Good to see you. Good to see you. Oh, ladies. You're looking fine, the same.
Thanks, Ronnie. Looking rather tasty yourself.
Well, I love your hair. It's so saturated.
Oh, it's nothing major. Just a little bit.
Yeah, 42 gallons.
Oh, you're taking me to Scoop Saturday night.
Saturday? Yeah, I believe I have that evening liberated.
Wonderful.
I hope so.
Brian, this is going to be tough for Doug. Gonna need your advice.
I was going to ask him out. Relax, Pats. It's only October.
Yeah, right.
Wait for me.
How about some tunes? Your dad sell aluminum siding?
No, he's the president of Tic Tac Tiles. Why?
This car sort of reminds me of my granddad's.
So how come you asked me out?
You went out with Cindy. She is Cindy Mancini.
You can't argue with that logic.
Bye, Kathy. Let's take it back to your car.
Look, there's Ronald and his dad, Chrysler.
Good evening, gentlemen. Sure.
I love station wagons.
I'll tell you what, you may like it, but once the cool see that car, they're gonna remember who he is.
Yeah.
This is an interesting mode of transport. Sort of antiquated like.
Yeah, I call it my undercover car.
Oh, you snake. Don't be shifty with the boys. This car's perfect. Complete with plush blanket. That's strategy, my man. All right.
This ain't just a car, man. This is an unleaded love machine.
Yeah, unleaded.
But you can make some sweet sweat back there, huh, Barb?
Hey, no complaints out of me.
Yeah, those jocks sure have great tasting cars, huh?
Shut up, Lester. I just don't get it.
I propose we look for a new port.
Just so.
Uh-oh. I know that look.
Okay, now hold your fire, Big John. Nobody's in the toxic waste.
Right there. Perfect.
No! 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 No!
Skill.
Oh, I don't know. For him, it's like an art form.
Oh, that's a real pleasant thought, Ronnie.
Oh, come on, well, guys.
Yo, Pats, keep an eye on my guy. I gotta hit the little girls.
All right, here you
go. It's what?
What?
You're taking me to Columbus Day Dance on the 16th.
I am?
Yep.
Well, what about Barbara? I thought she was your best friend.
Well, she is. But, I mean, you know, friends share their stuff with friends, you know what I mean?
Okay, there you go. Sure, friend, no problem.
I bet you're a really sexy dancer.
Oh, yes, you won that wager. I have moves that defy the laws of gravity.
Ooh, I bet you do.
Mm-hmm.
See you later, okay? Bye.
Dancer. Mm.
shit.
So, how was he?
Why didn't you like to know?
Don't worry, I will. I bet you're a really sexy dancer. Come on. Watch this, I'll bet I'll kick him. Mm-hmm.
Chuck? Chuck, I need a TV for a few minutes.
No.
Oh, Chuck, I just need to see the end of American Bandstand.
No.
Please, Chuck, I'm begging.
What we have here is something I just learned called the law of supply and demand.
I shall supply you this remote control, but I'm going to demand, say, $2.
Wrong. That is not how the economic theory works.
Look, I learned it in seventh grade, not Harvard.
Okay. Let me give you the theory of relativity. Either you put on Bandstand now, or I have one less relative.
I'll put on Bandstand just for you.
My famous gourmet pop. First screen shave.
Spotlight dance. Ultra new wave music. He's watching American Bandstand. I'm talking cheerleaders, football players, local socialites. He's not even associating with Kenneth anymore.
Come on, Chucky. I think it's groovy that he's making new friends. He's allowed to have fun.
He is. Besides, I was talking to my dad. It's like the dude's not weird anymore. Now that ain't Dick Clark.
We thank our two exchange students from Lower Swahili, Charles Kibangi and Sunday Ubuki, for recreating the African anteater ritual here on PBS African Cultural Hour.
Hey, let me know, babe. You know, I don't quite feel it with this too.
That's cool, all right.
Buck a piece, guys.
Kenneth, this is your big idea. Why don't you pay for this?
Oh. Come on, you guys.
Just what to do.
So do you work as hard off the field as you do on?
Well, I did letter in 3 indoor sports.
What a wonderful group of young adults we have this year.
But I better check the bathrooms.
Hello, Ronald.
Oh, hi, Mr. Webley.
Let's mingle.
Look, it's a nerd herd.
Ronnie, I'm becoming a punchaholic.
Come on, let's get out there and dance. I mean, this is a dance. What we're here to do, right, is dance? Come on, please, let's get out there.
Let's dance!
I have friends in exotic places.
Oh, yeah? Like where?
Rio?
Paris?
No. Really exotic.
Beautiful downtown Burbank.
Cindy!
Hey!
The name is Cindy, and don't call me babe.
Just want to say hello.
Then just say it.
Oh, why don't you get tranquil? Just trying to be friendly.
Why don't you be friendly with your flock, okay?
I owe all my friends to you.
Ha! Huh. Like I really want credit for this. I mean, your disciples are making fools of themselves. I mean, I've seen zombies with more individuality.
Yeah, like your college boy. What's his name? Biff?
Don't give me that. His name happens to be Brett.
There's a difference?
Alone at last. Hi, friend. You're awfully far away.
Sorry.
So tell me, are you into long distance relationships?
No.
No? I wanted you to reach out and touch someone.
Hello?
I happen to know that in the whole school, there's only one other titty quite this pretty.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I'm sick.
Yep, that's it.
I bet you've never seen two like this before.
Well, my parents do have cable.
Oh, they do, do they?
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Do you want to touch me?
Oh. Wow. I can't believe this.
It's so
good. Oh, God. Years, 3 months, and 5 days. That's a long time to wait for some tit.
Without an atmosphere, the Earth would be a far different place. It might look like the moon. Our exploration of the moon showed us that it is nearly a dead planet today. But it provided one very important piece of information.
I haven't seen or heard from you in 3 weeks. I'm not a mutant, Ron. I realize I may be obsolete in your new world, but I'm not dead.
We know now that the moon, as well as all the other bodies in the solar system, were heavily bombarded in their first 1 billion years. Then about 3.5 billion years ago, this bombardment slowed to a bare trickle. As most of the solid chunk.
You headed there, son? Whoa, Ronald! No mischief tonight. Now, the police are really cracking down this year.
Ed, come on, have a little faith.
See? All right, we set up there?
Yep.
Check it out. We got some whelped tomatoes, rotten eggs, and the piece de resistance. The ship bomb!
Human feces?
Nah, doggy do. But it's just as efficient, bro. Here, sniff.
A sniff? This?
God!
Hey, Ronnie!
Take it. What else are we doing?
Oh, dude, classic, man. We've done the same house 4 years in a row. Like tradition now, huh, Ricky?
You know it.
And your son is the most important mission. Drop that net on any punk that gets near our front door. I'm gonna personally deliver one of them to the police.
Yes, sir.
That's all I was telling you. You know, this guy is like
telling me.
Yeah. Excuse me. Ronnie said that you said that friends share, Patty. You've had him 2 weeks and
attacked him for 2 weeks.
Whoa, wait a minute. First of all, if I recall correctly, you still have Bobby. Secondly, you quit Ronnie, so that makes him public property.
You guys, that's real romantic. I mean, he sounds like a restroom. First of all, I don't have Bobby. And secondly, I didn't think that my best friends would be draped all over him like a cheap...
One person. He's cute, sweet, good. Oh, come on, you guys. A lady never talks.
Yeah, next time I see one, I'll remember that.
You're sick. There's the target.
You know, I know a better house. It's not very far from here. It's right down the street.
Our senior year. Our last mission. Final ship on.
It's tradition and shit. Let's go!
Come on!
Would you put him on each flank and you ship out front door?
No, I won't do it.
I told you you would do it.
You're still a nerd, huh?
Kill this shit.
No, I'll do it. I don't want to do this.
Do it now! Ronnie!
Do it, Ronnie!
Do it! Do it! Do it! Come on!
I got one!
Stop coming!
No, you're not!
Get them next year.
I don't think he'll be back.
This is a fine looking bird, Judy.
This is what got me an A in French class.
Ronald?
Thank you.
Let's see yours, sibling.
I didn't get mine yet.
You're the only one from kindergarten through college who didn't.
You didn't get yours yet? Let me repeat. I did not get mine yet.
Relax. There's no reason to raise your voice.
Back to nursery school.
These are my friends, okay?
You can say hello to your friends when you give me a chocolate milkshake extra thick.
What?
Read my lips. Chocolate milkshake extra thick.
Two C's, three B's, and one A. Outstanding, son.
Major improvement, Chucky.
Oh, yeah, big deal. Three B's and two C's. I've been getting straight A's since birth.
So
everybody doubts the whereabouts of my report card. That's real fair.
Nobody doubts you. You said you didn't get it yet.
And I didn't.
Hey, it's just for a concern, bro.
See, here is the primate example. You're raising a dog-chopping homicidal maniac. And what do? Every time you see him, you give him money.
Great.
Chilling.
Shut up, Chuck.
I was talking to Ma, Dad.
Shut up, Chuck. Here's your shake.
Thick. This isn't thick.
Oh, well, let me check the consistency. Looks thick to me.
No.
Make it a date.
Oh, sweetheart. Love you. Kenneth. Let me explain. It's been long enough. Will you talk to me, damn it? Bobby, you away, psycho, but you ain't invited.
Invited to what, man?
You talking my about? House? New Year's Day? Bowl games?
Saturday?
Cheesecake? Yeah!
Oh man, though, if I can recover from my party, they'll book me a couch.
You got it?
Give me a bed.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
We have money. Oh,
somebody wants your ass bad. Get it.
Hey.
Hi. Long time no talk, huh?
Yeah, I've been kind of busy.
Yeah, well, it's popularity, you know. It's real time consuming. I was thinking that maybe sometime you and I could go to the airplane graveyard.
You're not under any contractual obligation to me anymore.
I wrote a new poem. It's called Broken Moon. It starts...
Why don't you save it for your college boy?
I wrote it for you.
You ignored the Donald Miller dork for 17 years. Now you want to ride on the Ronnie Miller Express.
I don't want to ride the Ronnie Miller anything.
Looks like you're the only one.
Who? Iris? Oh, yeah, she's a big conquest. She's given more rides than Graham.
At least your ticket won't cost me $1,000.
Cindy.
Oh,
Hey, pass the punch, Bob.
I didn't pour the punch in yet.
Oh, yeah?
Cindy, that's straight vodka.
All right.
Great outfit.
Yeah, well, I just asked my mom if I could use it. She said yes.
Oh, progressive concept.
Well, we make a great couple. Me and my outfit.
Oh, sorry Bobby couldn't come home for the holidays. You must really miss him.
I've learned to appreciate the finer things in life. I even travel with my own wine. You never know the quality you may encounter at a soiree.
Very classy.
I'm into class. It's my new thing.
Oh, whoops. Sorry. Sorry. So dumb. Wasted. Okay. Oh, I'm going to use my slide now. Yeah. Take it easy. Jeez.
Oh, I'm so happy. I'm going to be the hottest guy in school.
I am hot.
Face it, Ronnie. You're it yet.
Oh. I'm it. And that's why you're with me.
Oh. You won't respect.
I respect you immensely and intensely.
You do?
I do. This summer, my wish is for you to hold me in your arms in a sea of deep blue. Together at last. Together as two.
Oh,
Ronnie. Damn, Bobby, what are you doing here?
It's New Year's.
So, Ricky and Bob tell me that you're a connoisseur of fine wine.
No shit. Are you new here?
Uh-huh. Just transferred.
Thanks, baby.
Hey, you guys, it's 11:27. Oh, I did it.
Yeah. Ronnie, Ira, we're
true friends and a royal lady. The only way to fly.
I'll change to that.
Check it out, Bobby.
Man, what's that, Scott?
Todd, who's Iris's latest victim?
Oh, you got it backwards, Bobby. He's victimizing her. Ronnie Miller's nailed every wench in school.
Connell Miller? He couldn't get nailed in woodshop.
Well, the man has reached legendary status this year, bro.
You ain't a legend until you score the captain of the cheerleaders. Come on, I don't buy it. Cindy?
Hey, no freaking way. Come on, quit. Even think of holding out on me.
I'll kill you.
Bobby!
job.
Good job.
Cindy and Bobby's relationship is so totally together.
Lawn boy. He makes 35 cents an hour.
Listen up, dude. Shit's gonna hit the fan.
I don't like this, and I'm not gonna put up with it.
You're faking, okay?
Bullshit!
No, it was an act. Bobby, he paid me.
Then that makes you a prostitute.
You. Even Bobby thinks we went out. Great, huh? Ha! All of you thought we were a couple. What a joke! Ronald Miller paid me 1,000 bucks to pretend I liked him. What a deal, huh? $1,000 to go out with him for a month. This guy. He bought me, and he bought all of you. He was sick and tired of being a nobody. Yeah, and he said that all of you guys would worship him if we went out. And I didn't believe that. I was like, no way. And he was right. No, he was right. Our little plan worked, didn't it, Ronald? A dance. A stupid dance. What a bunch of followers you guys are. I mean, at least I got paid. Come on.
Ricky?
John?
Get out of my house.
Yeah, we'll clear everything up tomorrow. Everything is cool, really. Oh, excuse me, I'm sorry. Excuse me.
Thank you. Excuse me. You ready to go?
I don't know you.
You sure knew me earlier.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Fucking idiot.
Could be worse if you'd be alone like that poor guy.
All right.
Siberia.
I know, man. Mutants over there won't even go near them.
You know, I knew it was scamming us all up. He went from, like, totally chic to totally geek.
Look at that, he's been banished.
You should have known that our kind won't mix with their kind.
Our kind? Come on, their kind, that's BS. He may be a moral left for now, but he had the fastening for 4 months.
Yeah, that's a good point. I mean, $250 a month for those cheerleaders isn't an unwise investment.
Yeah.
Check this out.
Incoming!
Direct hit.
Yo!
Didn't you take economics? You could head me for
$49.95.
It's the nerd mobile. Yeah, right, on automatic pilot. Like, we're not supposed to know he's spying on us in his spasmobile.
I sworn that a couple girls I knew got very comfortable in that spasmobile.
Acknowledge my existence. I think this is easy for me. I know I was an asshole to you and to thousands of others. Kenneth, it's you I gotta straighten this out with. You shit on my house, man. You shit on my
house. Quiz will cover every muscle from the levator scapula
to the spinalis thoracic. It will consist of 15 multiple choices and 5 mini essays. Your score will then account for 20% of your final grade. Good luck.
Thank you.
sorry about having to come in here. But I have to talk to you. I realize what a jerk I became. All I ever did was think about you. Dream about being part of your life. And then I got that stupid idea. And I let it turn me into something I'm not.
You sure did, sicko pervert. I remember you from the dance. You morally depraved psycho. Detention, 1 month.
Jackie, will you please
hand
me that over this? Thanks.
You nuked my brother.
What?
You took him from geek status to king status to no status.
Chucky Miller, right? He's resorted to sending his messenger boy.
Boy? I see no boy here. You think you shut me up?
I didn't. Well, let me try again.
Babe said it was good for my complexion.
There's a call for you on my line. Somebody named Donald.
I don't know anybody named Donald. Tell him I'm out of the country or something.
Okay.
I know she's in the country, Mrs. Mancini. I saw her today.
Well, my daughter doesn't know anyone named... Ronald, is that you? Why did you say your name is Donald?
I guess I made a mistake. Bye-bye.
Mom, what do you say? First he's a geek. And then you start going out with him. And then he's a geek again. Honey, I don't know what a geek is.
I guess at the present time... A geek is Ronald Miller.
Who says?
I told her that you had a chemical imbalance and you are seeking psychiatric help.
I need to talk to you. Every time I called, you were either taking a bath, washing your hair, or you're out of the country. That was a good one, by the way. I tried to get you alone at school, but I got a month's detention.
Yeah, you're very big in bathrooms, aren't you?
So, just hear me out. And then I'll leave you alone. Hey. Oh, you demolished me New Year's Eve.
But see, I realized you did me a favor. You brought me back to reality. All I ever wanted to do was get close to you. And then, when I finally got there, it wasn't me anymore. Cindy. Oh, Cindy. I was just hoping we could sort this out. You know, the real me and the real you. That's all.
Okay. But not at 6 o'clock in the morning.
Okay, I'll come back at 11.
I'll be washing my hair. Out of the country.
That's my favorite one.
Tell your mom I'm sorry.
Job.
Really? Oh my God.
What's happening, guys?
It's a nerd alert, man. It's in our quadrant, too.
Kenneth Werman with Patty? No way.
Thanks so much. I swear I don't know what I would have done without you, really.
No problem. Just take your time and follow the steps.
Okay.
Kenneth Wormman is trying to pull a Ronald McDonald Miller scam on us. He's probably trying to pay her off. Relax, but he's harmless. I'm sending him back to the minor leagues.
Be cool,
hey,
man.
Calm down. Dude, what do you think you're doing over here, twimp?
I was helping him with some math.
No, bullshit. You're trying to pull a Ronald Miller scam.
A what?
You better get back to your own side, or I'm gonna send you back to Geeksville in a milk cart.
Did you guys do something?
Return of the Living Dread.
Why don't you lay off?
I want you to go back where you belong, Jose.
Take your hands off, Kenneth, or I'll break your arm. Your pitching arm.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, don't make me laugh, lawn boy.
Let go.
No!
You broke your arm once before, remember? You fell out of our treehouse. Kenneth picked you up, and we carried you 12 blocks to the hospital.
Yeah, you cried all the way.
We were all friends then, remember? And now you want to end his life? Because he's talking to Patty on your side of the cafeteria. Oh, man, it's stupid. I know, because that's where I wanted to be. On your side. With your crowd, and I messed up. See, I tried to buy my way in. But Kenneth, he's not trying to buy anybody. He's just trying to make friends. Being himself. Cools, nerds, your side, my side. Man, it's all bullshit. It's just tough enough to be yourself.
Thank you.
should cover it.
Saw Kronk in the moon last night.
Yeah, me too. I gotta go, okay?
Yeah.
Bye-bye.
Cause I